Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Morgan. This is my channel Pisces Paperbacks, and today I'm going to be doing a mid-year reading goals update. So I know that it is August, but I did take 2 month-long breaks from both BookTube and reading this year. So it's like, this is my 6 months of reading check-in basically. And it's not my mid-year book freakout tag. This is literally, I'm gonna be going through all of the goals that I set for myself in my 2021 reading goals video, which I will link up above. And I will be letting you know how I've been doing. Spoiler alert, not very good. But it'll be fun to go through. I've adjusted some of my goals. I just wanna like let you know where I am, I don't know where you are, but I hope you appreciate where I am. And that's kind of what I'm going to be doing. I have my list right here, and let's start from the top. My first reading goal was that I wanted to set my like Goodreads reading goal for 150 books. And first of all, no fucking way is that gonna happen. No fucking way. I have actually lowered my reading goal to 100, and I feel really good about that. I'm thinking I'm going to kind of just keep my reading goal at 100 every year, and instead of like raising my Goodreads goal and like pushing myself that way, it'll just be like, oh, this is a nice benchmark that I'm hopefully going to pass every year, instead of like trying to raise that. I don't know if that makes any sense, but I've lowered it to 100. I feel really good about it, and that's kind of where I'm doing with that. I'm not gonna try and reach 150. If it happens, that would be crazy. That'd be crazy cool, but I don't think it's gonna happen. My second goal was to lower my owned unread TBR. So books that I own that I haven't read yet, I wanted to lower that number. If you've seen any of my hauls lately, also, I've not been successful. At the beginning of this year, I said in my video that I had around 75 unread books and that I wanted to get that down to 50 by way of listening to the audiobooks of books I already own. I now have like 120 unread books that I own, and I haven't listened to the audiobooks of any of them. So this has been a year of acquisition for me. I don't know. I need to acquire less. I would like to end the year with like 100, just a flat 100 unread books. That would be cool. My third goal was to continue my trend of reading nonfiction. So 2020 was a really big year for me in nonfiction. I actually read a lot of it, and I really enjoyed almost all of it. And this year I was like, I just want to continue this trend, not put too much pressure on myself. I want to read one nonfiction book a month, or if I could just do the overall thing, spread it out a little, 12 this year. I'm now 8 months into the year, and I've only read 3 nonfiction books, and they were all in January, I think. Maybe two in January and one in March. So that one's not going very well. I think what happened is that I haven't been listening to audiobooks as much. Like just in general, I just haven't been listening to audiobooks as much the past couple months. So the fact that I mostly read nonfiction through audiobooks is really affecting how much I read nonfiction in general, if that makes sense. The next one is something I have been thus far successful with. So this is the percentage of white authors that I've been reading. Last year I had like not a wake-up call moment, because it was something that I had been tangentially, peripherally aware of, but I really started paying attention to how many white authors I was reading, and basically was like, I don't want to make this like a numbers game where I'm like, I need to read this many authors of color and this many black authors per month and this many blah blah blah. I didn't want to like make quotas instead of like thoughtfully and mindfully choosing the authors and the books that I want to read. So I instead made my goal more that it would be like, I would like to every year read a smaller and smaller percentage of white authors, just to like make sure I keep an eye on it, but not make it something that I'm like trying to meet a quota for, you know what I mean? And so last year I finished the year having read 63% white authors, and this year at this point in the year that number is now at 54%. So thus far in the year, every book that I've started, 54% of them have been white authors, and the other part of that percentage has been authors of color, with, you know, divided up between there. And I'm okay with that. I would still like to see that go down, but again, my goal is not to like meet certain quotas. It's more just to be thoughtful and mindful about the books that I'm reading. Back to failure on the next one. My next goal was to do one dedicated review video per month. And first of all, I've only done, I think, one dedicated review video this entire year, and it was in January. Definitely not succeeding there. And honestly, I don't know. I still want to do review videos on a fairly consistent basis, but I've realized that I don't often have a book that I've read where I have enough thoughts and feelings about it to really make a dedicated discussion video about. Not that, you know, dedicated review videos need to be like long or like crazy in depth, but honestly, most of the time I just like don't feel like I have enough to say about any book in particular, or I'm not a very critical reader in that I like don't like pick up on specific notes as I'm reading. It's more just like general impressions, vibes, etc. So I don't know. I still want to think about doing more dedicated review videos, but I don't think they're going to be every month. And I think I just really have to like have a lot to say about a book. And then up next, I have my next thing, which is I wanted to do more year-long reading challenges as opposed to readathons. So I've said before, I find readathons really difficult for myself, for me, because I struggle with setting TBRs and like not mood reading. I really am a mood reader, or just like I have to read whatever's in for my library. It's not really something that I can plan ahead of time and then stick to. I struggle with that. So I was like, well, if there's something more broad, I can do that. And that is like a year-long reading challenge. And the two that I'm really trying to do this year are the Buzzword Readathon challenge and then the Reading Women challenge. So there are two year-long reading challenges with different numbers of prompts. And the Buzzword Readathon, you've probably heard of it. There's like a specific buzzword, and each month you want to read a book that has a title that includes that word. I have hit 5 of the 12 total prompts, which means that in the 7 months that have already happened, not including August, I read a book in 5 of them and I missed 2 of them. And then for the 4 remaining months of the year, I haven't done any of them yet. And basically, those 2 months that I missed, I'm allowing myself to read books in the future and go back to them, because they were months that I like didn't read anything. So I'm being gentle with myself for those. But going forward, I'm, you know, trying to read the books that are relevant in the months that is relevant. I don't know if that makes any sense, but 5 out of 12, not terrible. The next one though is the Reading Women Challenge. So the Reading Women podcast is like a feminist book podcast, and I didn't love the podcast, but I really like its reading challenge because it's focused on a very broad variety of books by women. So it will be more specific than other book like prompts, where it'll be like specifically read a book that was long listed for this particular prize, which rewards excellent fiction by Indian authors, or read a cookbook by a woman of color, or read a short story collection by a Caribbean author, and things like that. So for that prompt, for like that challenge, I've read books for 8 of the 24 prompts. So I'm not doing as well on this one, but I also think that that is going to improve. This is one where I'm going to be happy if I hit overall for the entire year 20 out of the 24. This is one where it would be really cool if I could get all of them, but I'm not gonna like beat myself up if I don't read all of them, because a lot of the prompts that I have left over are like nonfiction prompts, and like I've said, I've been struggling to read nonfiction, or like I said, there's a short story prompt. I really don't read short story collections. So it's like there's a poetry prompt. I really don't read poetry. Like I'm trying to meet the ones that interest me the most, and then after that, just be like, okay, what else do I have time for? I hope that makes sense. Lastly, I'm gonna go through the 5 books that I picked out at the top of the year for like the books that are gonna be my challenge books for this year, the 5 books I wanna read. I love watching the videos where people are like, 10 books I wanna read this year, or like 21 books I wanna read in 2021. I think the year has gotten high enough where it's like too constrictive to actually do lists like that, but it used to be fun in like 2015 books I wanna read in 2015, you know what I mean? But those are super fun. I cannot do those. That is too much restriction on the books that I'm gonna read that year. So I picked out 5 books I wanna challenge myself to read, and surprise, surprise, I've read none of them. But I'm gonna go through them with you anyway, just to let you know what I picked out for myself at the beginning of the year to read. So the first one I don't actually have with me because it's like behind piles of books. I can't get to it right now, but that is My Brilliant Friend by Elena Ferrante. This is a book that was a gift to me that I really want to read this year. I've been struggling with reading historical fiction, so I thought this would be good to get back into it because it's very popular. It's an international bestseller, and I will get to it eventually. Now that I look at it, I don't know if it's going to be this year. I don't know if this is the one that I'm going to read this year, but gosh darn it, I guess I'll try. Then I have Good Omens by Terry Pratchett and Neil Gaiman. who knows if I'm going to read this one. This is a fantasy about an angel and a devil who are tasked with finding the Antichrist, or the son of Satan, who I believe is like lost somewhere on earth. I think that's what this is about. I'm still very interested in this. I just haven't been in the mood. I don't know, man. I don't know. A Heart and a Body in the World by Deb Caletti. This is actually the one where I think I'm most likely going to read it this year. I very nearly picked it to be the book club book for like a book club I have with some in real life friends. And I think I'm gonna read this one soon. This is like a hard-hitting YA about a girl working through trauma by running cross-country. Very like Forrest Gump-esque there, but I think it's more, you know, trauma. So excited for this one, because I actually think, realistically, I think I'm going to read this one this year soon. Next I have The Vanishing Half by Brit Bennet. This is another one where I do think I'm going to read it this year. I think this is going to be more of a winter read, so I don't think it's going to be anytime soon. But this is a historical fiction about two very light-skinned sisters who go very separate, very different paths with their lives, and then what happens when their daughters meet and their paths cross again. So I'm very interested in this one. Glowing reviews from basically everyone I've seen who's read it. Again, I actually think I'm going to read this one this year. It's not very long, and this is one that I think I'm going to listen to the audiobook for in the winter. We'll see. And lastly, the last book I picked out for myself that I don't know about this one. The first two books are ones where I'm like, I don't think I'm gonna read them this year, but they were fun to pick out. Those last two that I talked about were ones where I was like, I think I'm actually gonna read these this year. This one, I literally have no idea. And that is The Priory of the Orange Tree, The Behemoth. This is an adult fantasy, and it's just enormous. I have not read a book this big in, I literally could not say how long it's been since I've read a book this big, and I would like to read it this year. I don't know if that's gonna happen. Either way, as you can see, 0 for 5, 0 for 5. I'm really killing it out here. Anyway, that is going to be the end of this little catch-up video. I have not been doing very well with the goals that I set for myself, but I'm very happy with how my reading's been lately, especially like the past month and a half. So like, who knows if it matters? I don't really think it matters. And we'll see how I do at the end of the year when I review this again. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know how you're doing on your reading goals. And I can't wait to see you next time. Bye.